Oh man. I need that. All right. Literally back from Kreator and Inflames, and wow. Holy shit. First of all, to get out the way, amazing. Kreator thrashed me around like no other, and it was badass. It was beautiful. It was crazy. It was just therapeutic. It was. And then Inflames got the and let me release it in the mosh pit because I'm trying to get back into the mosh pits because when Pantera comes, I'm gonna go freaking all out in that mosh pit because there'll be a Pantera mosh pit. So I just went to the very front with Kreator because I'm a big fan of Kreator and I just wanted to like take it all in, absorb that energy in a way, and then I released that shit in Inflames and it was amazing. 10 out of 10. Big F you to all the drunk assholes who are throwing beer at everyone, like throwing up in the air. F you guys, you pieces of shit. You can suck on Donald Trump's flaccid cock. You should have been swallowed in the back alley you were conceived in. Because screw you, mother. But anyway, that doesn't ruin the great freaking time that I had. First up, I want to say is I did the VIP, so I met them, I put it up on there. Unfortunately, I was the first person to meet them, so the lighting wasn't best, and I get it done, and the person who took it didn't take multiple, she took one photo, and I was like, oh, okay. And then we get like a little poster, which I'll show you. And then everybody else got the better colors, you know, the lights came on, I was like, oh shit. But I did get to meet them, and I got them to sign all of that. They actually brought stuff, but I was like, I didn't really want to bring anything. One of the first things I bought though was a Kreator hat. This survived the mosh pits for both and very good quality. I am not gonna say how much I spent today, tonight, or whatever it is. Kreator and Inflames, I'm really not. It was amazing though, and it was a lot. But for the bands that you really love, freaking just go for it. And this, my friends, is a damn fine hat. You know, works pretty well, fits really nicely. Like information, you know, like no picture or anything like that, so that kind of sucked. But I mean, nice embroidered, embroidered, and it looks cool. Okay, so let's go into the shirts because the shirts are pretty cool. So they are 2XL, but they're American 2XL, so they're very big. But I don't care because it means you get more of the awesome art. This was the first one that I bought. I bought a lot of shirts because why not? That looks amazing. I am so tempted to get that tattooed on me because I need a Kreator tattoo and it's really hard to find the right Kreator tattoo. But last year I got the right Megadeth tattoo, so hopefully I can do that. And then that's the back for that one, which looks pretty damn sick. Unfortunately, this one was the one that got the beer on it, but it looks amazing and I'm a very big fan. Like, that's just amazing. It's sick. It's beautiful. 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10. All right. Next up, this was cool. So, Kreator being one of my favorite thrash bands, I was lucky enough to catch the drummers at the end. I caught his little drummy stick thing, and it's beaten. I don't know if you can see that, but this guy went crazy on it, man. He did good. I do sort of wish it had like Kreator written on it. That would have been pretty cool. But honestly, I caught it. I never thought in my life I'd ever catch one of these, and I did. Hells yeah. I'm gonna put that away somewhere. And then we got the VIP poster, which I thought was pretty cool. Definitely worth the money. They were pretty good. They actually stayed, like the Inflames guys, they actually apparently just got a photo done and that was it. Kreator got a photo done. And they stayed around a bit and like signed stuff, and I thought that was really awesome. This is the Kreator Clash of the Titans, which I'm gonna get put away and probably have that in there as well. It didn't come like it came like straight open. It didn't actually come like this, which I thought was dumb because a lot of us probably were like, it's gonna get ruined, and it, you know, probably all of them did, but hey, it's gonna look fine in the end. So that's that. Next up, I bought a lot. You got the bag, which again, I'm not gonna say how much it was. It was a lot of money for a bag, but this is actually a really good bag. Like, it's better quality than this bag, and definitely better quality than the $20 incantation bag I got. And this one actually looks pretty nice. It actually is pretty badass. It's got like the demon. Reminds me of Doom too. And as a big Doom fan, I'm just like, hell yeah. Looks like a Hell Knight. But that's a really nice bag. You know, I don't really use many bags often, and you know, maybe I'll give it to my partner because Valentine's Day is today, tomorrow. No, hang on. Yes, it's today. Happy Valentine's Day, honey. Love you. You want the bag? I love it. But what's in the bag? What's in the bag? What's in the bag? More shirts. Like I said, I bought a lot of stuff. So, all right. So I bought Inflames because, of course, I do like Inflames, and I think they had some great art. So I bought that, which again looks amazing. And just like the Kreator one, it does indeed have the back, and I'm probably gonna wear that tomorrow. So yeah, that was amazing too. And then I got this. So this one, this was a lot of money, and even I was like arming because I was like, this is a shit ton of money. But online, it's not too off the mark. Probably $20 more than it should have been. But it's a hoodie. You know, the front looks pretty cool. But the back looks very nice as well, if you can see that. Which is similar to the like what the shirt has, but obviously a different variation. And I like that. I thought that was really, really cool. And I was like, yeah, nah, screw it. I'll get it. I mean, I'm not going to say how much it was, but I did buy a Kreator one that was similar to this and not as good. And that was like 80, 90 bucks. So, and while this did cost more, the quality is actually pretty good. And that's the thing. The quality, like these things did cost a lot of money, but the quality of what you get is actually pretty damn cool. So, yeah. What else does my bag of grease have? More stuff. Okay. I know, it feels like I'm just doing an unboxing right now. Oh, sorry. I got a Kreator pin, which I'm going to put on my keys, because, of course, that's awesome. I'm going to leave those there. And then I got two more shirts, because, of course, I did. So, another one was the Inflames. So, basically got two Inflames and three Kreator out of, like, the four. So, that was the other Inflames, which was really nice. I really enjoyed it. That one, like, this is basically the tour one. So they had, like, one for the overall tour, and then they've got the one where it's just Australia, like the Clash of the Titans Australian one. So I got those because they look amazing as well. And, like, why not? And then the Kreator one, which is the same thing almost, where it was that, which, yeah, pretty much the same thing. The Australian version looks sick, and I was like, yeah, hell yeah, I was going to get those. These ones definitely took my breath away. There was, like, another one for Kreator, and I was like, oh, I was so tempted, but I'm like, I spend too much money. Whatever, I'm probably going to do the same thing when Pantera comes. Save up your money, rah, rah, rah. It was fine. Now, that unboxing of stuff is done. Let's talk about Kreator itself. Holy shit. So, first of all, second time seeing them, and they were amazing. They were in a bigger area. They sounded better. They had the most beautiful backdrop I've ever seen in a very long time. It had the demon. It had a really nice backdrop. It had like hanging bodies. It had the really red lighting. It was so like, it had a vision. It had a semblance of creativity. It was alive. It was so good. The lighting, the rays of light, the dead decaying bodies, the red of that light, the smoke that had spewing up. It just felt so good, and it felt like they were telling a violent, thrashy story, and it was just amazing. 10 out of 10. Like, theatrics alone, 10 out of 10. Cannot possibly say anything negative about it. And then you had the music. You had, obviously, stuff from the new album, which was fantastic. They had, like, Strongest of the Strong and all that, and Uber Alice, they gave us Coma of Souls stuff. They gave us War Curse, Hordes of Chaos, Phantom Antichrist, which was amazing. No Gods of Violence, which I really would have loved. They did do some songs from Gods of Violence, but it was a mix of all their stuff. Pleasure to Kill, you know, all the good stuff. Now, granted, I saw them years ago, in like 2017, 2018, when they were here with Vader. So I did hear Gods of Violence live, and I'm like, I'm okay with that. So they got a good mixture, you know. New, old, really good stuff, really rocked out, and we went crazy. There was Circle Pits.
Yeah.
freaking loved it. I didn't jump in to those then because Kreator's being such one of my favorite bands and just one of the best thrash bands ever. I wanted to kind of like bring all that energy in and just like suck it up and just, and then boom, 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 release it over time, which I did when I did got to Inflames, which was another great band. I do think Kreator was better, and I'm happy that Kreator was the first band because I got to just eat it up more. But Inflames was great. They were crushing and just full on crazy and amazing, and I had no problems at all ever. And since I was in the mosh pit, it was just very fun to bring it all in. You know, there was a few drunks in there and people getting thrown over. There might have almost been a fight, but luckily the drunk was not getting into a fight because he was a fucking idiot. There was a few women that were like just like rushed in and were just going crazy, and I was like, damn, okay, don't get in that way, because women in the mosh pit, they go crazy, and it was just like, damn, do not. There was a guy that had his shirt off, and he was fucking drenched with sweat. This guy was drenched, and I remember being in the pit with him, and like as soon as my hand touched his body, it just slipped off. Like, it was that crazy. It was just like, wow. And that's the great thing. We have two great bands like that. You get one to kind of pure the energy up, build you up, and then you freaking smash it in with the next band, and I freaking loved it, and I'm definitely going to do that for now on. Just one band, take it in, the next band, smash it out. Though granted, it would also help that the band, the venue that I was at, had a cloakroom, so that also helps if you get a cloakroom and you want to buy a whole lot of shit. Like, damn, man. I'm still full of energy, and I put out a lot of energy, man. I also apologize for all the people that I accidentally pushed over. When I get into a pit, I try not to go crazy, and went a bit crazy. But yeah, overall, it was amazing. Kreator wins in basically style, substance, imagination. Just it was like a painting. It was like a mise-en-scene. It just, the visuals and what they had out for everyone to see just brought in this, it helped accentuate the music and just made you just feel it more, you know. Even as crazy as it sounds, closing your eyes, similar to how Catatonia, you can close your eyes and the thrash kind of takes over, depending on the song. Some of their songs can be a bit of a roar, but some of their songs kind of build up, and then, you know. And that was fantastic. Like, I can't stress enough. Kreator, 10 out of 10. Mwah. Freaking amazing. Good songs. Good energy, good love. You know, he was building us up. He's getting us going, yo, yo, scream, scream. Ah! And everybody screamed. And everyone's just like getting up. And he's like, come on, guys, let's do a circle pit. Let's do a wall of death. And then bam, like it was just, they know what they're doing. They've been doing it so long. And then they knew that they were building us up because then bam, Inflames comes on. And Inflames were just as good to an extent. I do think Kreator was better, but Inflames were like, building people up, and then they just were like, guys, just go crazy, put down your phones, and just be in the pit, be in the moment, and just have a good time, and we did. Yeah, I recorded some songs every now and then, but not as much, because I took their advice. I was like, yeah, okay, let's do this. So I jumped in the pit, and just running around, and yeah, sweaty and everything, and it was worth it, so worth it. If you ever get a chance for VIP, do it, obviously depending on what you like more. I like this one more. And yeah, I'll leave you with some clips. Obviously, I had some clips here. My photo of me with them. Great venue too. Probably one of the best in Adelaide. And I really hope more metal bands go there. There's going to be a few good ones there. So yeah. Somewhat expensive because I'm not sure if it's just, I don't know how that works, but I wonder if expenses go towards how good the venue is at times. I don't know, but then again, the shirts were also, like, the shirts I bought were cheaper than what Catatonia was selling, so who knows. In the end, though, totally worth it. Got to meet one of my favourite bands. All I need is a goddamn tattoo, but I don't know what to get. Whatever, man. I'll get there. Anyway, that is Aussie Viking Art Seal and Valhalla. Freaking rock hard, party on, you beautiful bastards. See you in Valhalla. Bye.